Very cold air to continue across the north coast, as I'm sure you've noticed by now. We've got an Arctic air mass sitting across the region. This weekend, most of the moisture slid south into Southern California, producing the mudslides after a little over an inch to an inch and a half of rain in the LA basin. All that moisture missed us, but we definitely caught plenty of cold air across the region. Mostly clear tonight and cold again. Another hard freeze expected this evening. A gradual increase in the cloud cover here through the end of the week will help to warm things up. But check out the highs for today here. We had a 40 in Brookings, 38 in Newark and Orleans. Very cold across the area. Mid-40s prevailing out there. We'll be in that range again coming up tomorrow with a bit more cloud cover headed our way here. Beginning tomorrow night into Thursday. Now that'll help warm our overnight lows as we see that cloud blanket move into the area. With it comes a chance of showers by Thursday evening. We'll be looking at some light rain. Looks like most of the moisture will stay to our south again. Classic El Nino pattern. But nonetheless, I would expect more moisture into the Bay Area and LA than what we're going to see over the next several days. Later in the weekend, we will see a better chance of moisture out of some of these disturbances you see moving across the Pacific. So, chance of showers returns late Thursday, continuing on and off Friday with snow levels down to about 3,000 feet, gradually warming into the weekend. Snow levels will rise and we will hang on to a chance of showers pretty much through the weekend and into early next week as temperatures will warm back to more seasonal norms for this time of year. So just a few more days of this very cold air, another night of hard freezes. Tomorrow night will be a little warmer as we'll see a few more clouds moving in our direction. Right now, all that cloud cover is moving ashore to our south, and that trend will continue here through the evening hours. We're not the only one picking up winter weather. Check out the rest of the nation. Heavy rain and thunderstorm activity moving across the southeast, turning to snow as it moves into the mid-Atlantic and the upper Midwest with some very cold air for much of the nation here. Another Arctic blast extending down into the northern plains and into the midsection of the country. We're right on the western edge of that cold air, and you know what that means. We look at Seattle and Portland here today, 32 for our highs, with our daytime highs in the mid to low 40s here. So again, we aren't the only ones chilling out here across the country. For tonight, we'll look for our lows. Well, here's a look at the statewide highs for tomorrow. Look at Medford, 25. For a high with our overnight lows again in the mid to upper 20s at the coast, upper teens to low 20s once more out across the interior. Another hard freeze headed our way with the daytime highs tomorrow still in the mid to upper 40s range. Don't see any 50s creeping in there at all, with winds light and variable out of the northeast at about 5 or thereabouts. And taking a look at the 7-day forecast here, we bring a chance of showers in Thursday night. Snow levels lowering through the day on Friday to about 3,000 feet, and then shower potential will remain on and off into the beginning of the week. Now, with the increase in the cloud cover, we'll see overnight lows warming up a tad, but still on the cold side, with, again, some pretty good snow expected in the local mountains starting out late Thursday into Friday at about 3,000 feet, and then gradually going back up to about 4,000 here by Saturday. From the looks of things, but still, that'll leave a fresh batch of the white stuff in the local mountains. Taking a look at our 3-degree contestant for tonight, Nolan Barnett of Fairhaven wins the desk clock from Redwood Coast Cellular. Gene Scranton of Fortuna looking for $120 coming up tomorrow night, and from my new best friend, Jim Kiyojima. Remember him? He got $450.
Oh, yeah.
And you got a
Christmas
card?
Card, yeah. New best friend.
Very nice. Money in it, or did he?
No.
No,
he got the money, I got the card.
Very nice card, though.
No kickback. Nice card. Yeah.
Thanks,
Jim.
And now, Maple Shot, sports, and any of the Lady Jacks on the court as we speak.
Yeah, and they're looking, maybe they'll win tonight, send me a Christmas card.
You return the Eureka football team prepares for the Division II championship game, and Danica Patrick, it's a second job. Stay with us. Sports is next.